So I wanted to show you a real-life example of a badly implemented alt text for images and how much it can hurt the user's experience. Not only that, but it can hurt the user's understanding of the page, especially if you put important information in an image but do not provide a good alt text. Here I am in the Amazon page of this book, and let's start browsing it and see what we find. So as we go down, we see that there's a section here that says from the publisher. And inside here, we have images of text, which I noticed Amazon does a lot. It has a lot of images of text in their products, especially in books, where they put important information such as testimonials, awards, and it has no other text equivalent. Let's see if the first image that reads one of the most anticipated books of fall 2020. Okay, this is images of text, which means that when you have that, you have to transcribe the text inside the alt attribute of the image. Let's check the alt attribute of this image. The alt attribute of the image is Nicholas Sparks, The Return, Christmas Gifts. Whereas the text of the image is something completely else. So this is really badly implemented alt text. And what's even worse is I don't see any text alternative next to the image. So you can sort of get away with bad alt text if there is the equivalent text next to the image. It's still not a good idea, but it's better than nothing. But in this section, it says from the publisher, the only information is images of text. So a screen reader user is not going to read one of the most anticipated books of the fall of 2020 and then the names of the, I think, magazines like Parade, Pop Sugar, Travel. The screen reader is going to announce Nicholas Sparks, The Return, Christmas Gifts, which is useless and it's not what the image tells. And then right below this image, we have testimonials from various TVs, magazines. You know how books work. You need people and magazines giving testimonials so you can sell your book. So let's see their alt text of the image is the same. Nicholas Sparks, The Return, Christmas Gifts. Nicholas Sparks, The Return, Christmas Gifts. It is absolutely terrible. And it just takes away so much from the user experience. This is not going to help a user with a screen reader. This is terrible accessibility. So I just wanted to show you how important it is for good alt text. Now, let's say that the alt text was correct. Let's say that they did everything right, that the alt text was exactly as the images of text were saying. You should avoid images of text as much as possible because they're very inaccessible. I'm going to show you right now, I have zoomed 150% and I'm going to zoom a little bit more. So I'm going to zoom 175, let's zoom 200% because 200% is in the WYGAC. It says that content must still be accessible and readable at 200%. As you can see, I have zoomed 200% and the text becomes very blurry. And why is that? Well, it becomes blurry because images of text is not like electronic text. It depends on the pixel of the image itself. So every time you zoom in, the browser has to repaint the image. And since it's not electronic text, it gets blurry. And that's why it makes it so inaccessible. So that's 200%. So if someone who has visual impairment or just haven't found their glasses or doesn't want to get up from the chair and get their glasses, if they just prefer to browse zoomed in, that's fine too. They'll have difficult time reading this text because it doesn't scale on zoomed in, when zoomed in. Now I'm going to zoom in 400%, which is also in the WYGAC. See, the image itself cuts off because it's such a big image that it has to cut off from the screen. Either that or they haven't coded it correctly to scale as the size zooms in. But even if it did, if they did code it correctly to scale as it zooms in, see how blurry it is. It's just terrible user experience. And again, I am scrolling down and these three images are just appearing horribly. So I'm going to zoom back into 150% and I want to look at another book. Okay, this is a different book that I opened and they have from the publisher as well. So let's check its alt text to see if they did a better job. Now, these images of text are showing, again, testimonials from various newspapers, magazines, and the middle image says Reese Witherspoon, ex Hello Sunshine book club pick. So this book was picked by Reese Witherspoon's book club, which is great because it's going to help the book sell. Okay, so let's check the alt text. Alt text missing. So actually, I checked and there's no alt text. What they did is they added the alt attribute, but they made it null. So you do that when you want the screen reader, your screen reader to skip an image. And that's absolutely fine. If the image is decorative, if right next to the images there's a text representation, you don't need the screen reader to repeat something twice. No alt attribute is absolutely fine if the context requires it. You might be thinking, oh, but Stephanie, look at the first image. The first image is transcribed below. Yes, it is transcribed below, which is good, but it's not transcribed inside this section, okay? And some users, they navigate the website using H, the H key via headings. So it's still not compatible to the WCAG. So, and the second, but however, the second image reads Witherspoon x Sunshine Book Club. I'm going to try to see if there is a. I'm going to search the page now to see if there is the same text inside the page. So I'm going to type Reese Witherspoon in the search bar. Okay, so there is an alternative text at the top of the page, but there is not, the alternative text is nowhere near the image. So again, not confirmed. And let's see if Busto has an alternative text somewhere in the page. I'm going to write Busto. Okay. A lush mystery is perfect friends of Barbara King's lover. Okay, Busto here. Okay, Busto. That's such a funny name. Has no alternative text inside the page. So the user would completely miss this testimonial. Everybody thinking, well, Stephanie, what's the big deal? Well, it is a big deal. So what if they're a fan of this, whatever that is, magazine, website, I don't know. What if it's important for them to see, okay, so a lot of magazines or web publications love this book. Maybe it's something I would like too. It doesn't really matter. What it matters is that you create an accessible interface for everybody. And alt text, yes, I know it's difficult because alt text for images, it depends on the context a lot. So you have to look at it individually. But it's still relatively easy to add the correct alt text. You just have to think about it for more than like 1 minute, like those people did. Apparently, they don't care about it. So I just want to show you how important it is, and wherever possible, avoid images of text. Like if you want to have these, like I think they added images because they wanted it to look beautiful. You can do that with CSS and HTML, and it can be accessible off the bat. So that's pretty much it about alt. Don't forget to like the video and subscribe to the channel, and yeah, got accessible websites.